And somebody just called to make a comment. Phil,
thank you.
Come over here and tell me what he was saying. He was saying it was like the Beatles' new record.
Well, what he thought was that it sounded like the Beatles' new records, and I was saying that I thought that nobody could say whether or not the Beatles had heard this stuff from Ives or any of the people who did it before or not. I kind of think that they thought of it themselves, because it's possible for you to discover stuff that other people have done for yourself.
Right. Like a lot of people discovered,
radium or...
Yeah, something like that.
All at the same time.
Yeah, right.
And
the
law of gravitation.
A lot of people
those things are in the air, and the Beatles have taken the lead in bringing it into popular music, and I'm, for one, I'm glad.
Right, and they do it in their own way. It's the pure Beatles. No, it's still the Beatles.
And still so tasty.
Yeah,
and constantly changing and never hung up in one particular thing.
Oh, yeah.
You know, we were in no hurry. We weren't going anywhere or anything, but just in case anyone panicked, man, you know. It would do Pigpen in if we both hung up on him and turned off his radio. You know?
Yeah, sorry about that, Ping.
Pigpen, we're sorry.
Public apology. I would call Ian and Sylvia a little variety from what we've had up to now. Anything you care to say about them, or why you like them, or why you picked them?
They just sing good, mostly. And these particular songs, Sylvia sings the one, Jealous Lover, and by herself, it's enough to chill your bones. And the next one is a fine desperado ballad in a great tradition with some nice guitar playing on it.
Okay, let's try Ian and Sylvia and the Jealous Lover.
Herself in men's attire, and so gaily she was dressed, a-thinking to meet her own true love, the one that she loved best. But when he saw her a-coming, he cried out, "Who is there? It is my eldest brother, to meet my dear. But how soon will I deceive him? For his butcher I will be. He shall not live to enjoy my love, nor yet to bother me." He fired right at him as he thought, which caused his loved one to fall. And in her tender bosom he lodged a fatal ball. "I fall, I fall, I fall," said she, "I fall unto the ground. Oh, Jimmy, cruel Jimmy, you have gave me my death wound. Come, look at the crimson tide that from my heart does flow. Oh, Jimmy, cruel Jimmy, how could you use me so?" And when he saw what he had done, he tore his loving hair. Another loaded pistol for himself he did repair. "I shall die for the love of Mary. I shall die for the life of thee. Come all bold lads and bold lassies, be aware of jealousy."
All right, another one by Ian and Sylvia. This is Four Road By. Phil says it's a desperado song.
Wild Alley. them I'd have known them anywhere. Willie Palmer's stallion was no $20 cayuse, and when the wild one stole him, he hightailed it in town. Usher in those days was keeping order in the district, but before he'd ridden 30 miles, the McLean boy shot him down. Wild alley fair. A shepherd known as Kelly saw the wild bunches they passed, and they shot him with a rifle, and they took his watch and chain. When the posse found them, they were in a lonely cabin. A hunger took their fight away, and no one else was slain. Oh, Rhode Island, roll through here, three McLean boys in that wild alley fair. In January 1881, the first time in that province that they'd strung up brothers free, and the Sungill 19 Germans crossed the seas back in 17. One thing that's for damn sure, they're a wild old family. Oh, Rhode Island, rode through here, three McLean boys in that wild attic there.
And Sylvia and Four Rode By. Skip James is the next thing you got. Tell me about Skip James.
He's a famous Delta blues singer, as it says right here on the cover.
Greatest of the.
But everybody thought he was dead for the longest time. And everybody said, Skip James, yeah, he's dead. But his old 78s were around, and people would listen to him and all. You know, he's really good, is what it's all about.
And then they found out he was alive.
Right, they found out he was alive.
Glenn Miller will turn up the same way.
He had Amelia Earhart, Judge Crater.
Judge Crater, a whole bunch of them, with his trombone, Martin Foreman. I know they're all Argentina, right?
Right.
Okay, this is Skip James and Hard Time
Killing
Floor Blues.
You know you say you had money, you gotta be sure that these hard times gonna kill you. Just drive along slow.
That's Aretha Franklin, and from her new Atlantic LP, I Never Loved a Man the Way I Love You. We were talking about Phil Spector a little while ago, and the kind of record producing he does, which is totally creative thing from the beginning as a producer. This is one of the great examples of it, I think, this Righteous Brothers record we're about to play. Someday I'm going to have Phil on the show, and there's one thing I'm going to get him to play, and that is a tape of the track for this record.
The instrumental track.
Yeah. With him singing the parts.
Does it exist?
Oh, yeah. I've heard the record. He played it for me one night at his house. You know, he's in that strange baronial mansion he lives in L.A. And I had heard about the record from Bobby Dale and Tommy LaPuma, who's a producer down there, about the tape. And it's, you know, a strange, strange sound. Spector's voice, because he has a really peculiar voice in singing. Has not been heard on record since To Know Him Is to Love Him.
You singing parts in that?
Yeah.
I think he played guitar on too.
Yeah.
The Mojo Navigator has a thing about all his records.
Yeah, they did a nice discography on him.
Yeah.
He was, Phil had a record out that was probably the first S&M record anybody ever came along with called She Hit Me and It Felt Like a Kiss, or He Hit Me and It Felt Like a Kiss. Remember that?
Oh, right.
And they finally had to pull it off the market because there was so many protests. And on and on. Here's the Righteous Brothers, and you've lost that loving feeling.
You never close your eyes anymore when I kiss your lips. There's no tenderness like grief in your fingertips. You're trying hard not to show it, but baby, how's that love and feeling record, Slightest Scratch, 2000, playing in the middle of the night again. Spectre has not done anything for a long time. He keeps saying, I'm old-fashioned, I'm totally out of it now, I'm not going to make any more records.
I hear he's making some strange movie in Mexico.
He wants to. He never got down there. The whole project blew up just as everybody was getting ready to get on the boat. But he has been in the studio with Ike and Tina Turner again.
Again. Oh, yeah. Far out. Good. Hmm.
So,
well, if the results of that one are as good as the last one.
This one. The one coming
the
up.
The one coming up.
Yeah. Well, he had the one record, of course, that was a big success in England.
Which
one?
River Deep?
River Deep, Mountain High, which got to, I think, number four on the English charts. And Phil took an ad in Billboard at the time, do you remember? With the British flag, and the line was something about King George was right. Because none of the radio stations in this country would play it at that time. Ike and Tina Turner. Ike Turner is one of the great minds of all time. You ever talked to Ike any period of time?
No.
I'd love to get him on the show sometime. Let him tell the world, you know, how he got started. He's got a great success story. This is the very record we were just discussing. Ike and Tina Turner and a Phil Spector production, River Deep, Mountain High.
When I was a little girl, I had a rag doll, only doll I've ever owned. Now I love you just the way I love that rag doll, but only now my love has grown. And it gets
that's by Ike and Tina Turner, River Deep, Mountain High. I don't think that record's ever been played in this town before.
Really?
I know it's never played in any radio station.
That is a crime.
Right. I think we should start playing it every night.
Would you think so? I will give you the record if you'll play it
every night. All right, good. I'll play it every night.
Too much. Please do.
And maybe people will go out and buy it, and we'll put Phil back in business and get him up here.
That'd be nice, yeah.
One interview with Phil Spector, and it might be all over for the radio station. But it'd be worth it, you know? Lou Rawls, he's one of the younger blues singers around, does a thing that's, I think, very peculiarly his own.
This is the only record of his that I ever heard, except for Blues for Four-String Guitar, which seemed a little bit ostentatious.
You might even say, but he did...
This was really tasty with
that other famous song. What was that?
Tobacco Road.
Tobacco Road. Right?
I saw him working one night in Oakland with Bobby Bland and Jimmy Witherspoon.
Wow.
Which was a fine trio for an evening. This is Lou Rawls and Trouble Down Here Below.
Top of the mountain. Beatle.
Tom Donahue at KMPX 107 on your FM dial in San Francisco. We're playing records 8 until 12 midnight. Our guests tonight are Phil Lesh and Jerry Garcia from the Grateful Dead. Gotta Get Away, that's by the Rolling Stones. Tom Donahue here with Phil and Jerry. Let's hear you talk a little bit about Otis Redding.
Oh, well, we worked with